Today on Review This Thing, we're going to review this thing, the PepperBall Mobile. This is Adrian with Review This Thing. Before we get into the PepperBall Mobile, do us a big favor, click that subscribe button and that notification bell. If you have a PepperBall Mobile, do us another favor and comment below and let us know what you think. If you have any questions, ask those below. Share the video, like it. Get as many people as you can to watch it. That just helps make sure that YouTube knows everybody wants to watch it. Also, come back next week. We have a brand new review every week about all sorts of different things. So check back. You don't want to miss it. And check out all kinds of our other content too while you're here. Now that we've covered all that, let's go ahead and review the PepperBall Mobile. As always, we cover the facts. The first part is fit. The PepperBall Mobile is about 9 inches long, and fully loaded, it weighs about 1.5 pounds. I have fairly small hands, and you can see that it fits my hand pretty well. I'm not struggling to get around it or even struggling to reach the trigger, so size-wise, that works pretty well. To hold it, it actually feels a little heavier than 1.5 pounds. It's not, I measured it. But the good thing about the weight of it is that it feels sturdy and feels like you could have good control of it. The only thing that's a little bit of a downside for me is that I have a fairly small purse, and so this won't really fit in my purse. But if you have, you know, a shoulder bag or a larger purse, backpack, this will fit perfectly right into that. Overall, I think the size is actually pretty necessary for what it does, to have the power to shoot the number of pepper balls that it does shoot and hold the air canister. I think size-wise, it's exactly where it needs to be. In my perfect world, the PepperBall Mobile would be a little smaller so I could fit it in my purse, but that's not going to keep me from liking it or keep me from being able to use it. So, because of that, I'm going to give fit a 4.8 out of 5. Now, is the PepperBall Mobile as advertised? The number one thing PepperBall advertises for all their devices is that it is a safe, effective, powerful, non-lethal self-defense weapon for people of any walk of life. The main thing that really excited me when I saw this device online was the ability to protect yourself very well in a non-lethal situation. Just a little bit before we really get into it, how does this thing work? So inside there is a place for a CO2 cartridge similar to like a paintball gun. And then there's also a compartment where you put the projectiles, which look a lot like paintballs. What makes these different is that they are not filled with paint. The purple ones, the inert ones, are filled with like a baby powder. The red projectiles are filled with PAVA, which is a synthetic capsaicinoid. It's based on one of the 6 hottest capsaicinoids found in pepper plants. So whenever that thing hits, it explodes and it creates like a 12-foot wall of pepper spray. Now, if you've watched any of our other videos, you have seen that we really enjoy hunting. One of the things with hunting is that before you pull that trigger, there is this awareness in your mind that you are about to take a life. If carrying a handgun and you are placed in a situation where you may have to protect yourself, would that realization that the pull of that trigger would lead possibly to taking a human life, would that delay you or make you more hesitant and not want to do it and then put yourself in actually more danger because you're not ready or willing? So the PepperBall device really excited me because it gives you the ability to protect yourself very, very well while removing that fear or that hesitancy about having a lethal solution. One piece of that is that it advertises to be able to shoot 40 feet effectively. When we tested it out, we stepped off 40 feet so we could see how it would do, and it was definitely accurate and even still felt like it could be accurate even a little bit further than 40 feet. In addition to being able to launch 40 feet, it also is advertised to have powerful stopping power and impact power. Whenever we shot our pepper ball, the projectiles would travel anywhere from 259 to, we got it up to, I think, 281 feet per second muzzle velocity. You can see the way that the powder splatters on this plywood and the noise that it makes, that at 40 feet, it definitely packs a punch and has a very forceful impact. We also tested the impact on this water jug at about 8 yards away. I shot at it 3 times. I missed the first time, but the next 2 times I hit the jug. The first time it just, I think, went straight through. The second time it hit the same spot and busted, and you can see water started coming out of the jug. So that tells me that there would definitely be enough force behind that to stop someone. I have a friend who actually plays paintball, and I asked him to send me some pictures of the result of him being hit with paintballs. I'm not sure speed-wise or the difference of the size of projectile, but just this is an example of what a CO2-propelled cartridge can do. And that stopping power is probably enough to deter someone from coming at you. But then, like we talked about, keep in mind that these red projectiles have that pepper in them. That they advertise to have a 12-foot cloud of pepper. So if you hit even near the person, then that pepper is going to get in their face and their esophagus and their eyes and their skin and do all the effects of, you know, if you spray bear spray or pepper spray at a person. Now, we did not test the pepper or the force of the projectiles because, number one, I'm not getting shot with it. And number two, I couldn't get anybody else to volunteer either. One really cool thing about the device is they advertise the ability to practice. It does come with some of those, they call them inert projectiles, which are just filled with that baby powder. So you can practice, make sure you have a good feel of the trigger, make sure you have a good ability to aim the laser, all those sorts of things. So you can make sure that you feel good with it and comfortable with it before you ever have to actually use it. So is the PepperBall Mobile as advertised? Based on everything that we've seen so far and just the assumption that the pepper would do what it says, we're going to have to say that absolutely the PepperBall Mobile is as advertised. 5 out of 5. Now onto construction and durability. First, this device is also a 350 lumen flashlight. Now, that's not super bright, but the cool thing is if you're walking, say, to your car from a store or walking the dog in the neighborhood, you can have it on and carry it and use it like a flashlight, and it's not alarming. You're not going to signal someone that you're carrying a weapon. And I like that because you're able to carry it, have it ready, have it in your hand, not have to go digging through a bag for it or something like that. Next, I would say this device is very sturdy and well built. I read somewhere where it's metal, but it almost feels like just a really heavy plastic. And then the grip part is a little bit more soft touch, so you're not as likely to drop it. It also comes with this wrist strap, so if you were to drop it, it's there. You don't have to worry about holding on to it the whole time. So overall, I feel like it's very sturdy and heavy enough to be well built. And firing the pepper ball is actually pretty easy once you've practiced. I will say my first impression of the trigger is that it's kind of hard to push. I actually think that's probably a good thing because it's not accidentally going to go off if you accidentally have it on fire instead of safe. But the big thing I would recommend, number one, is they give you the opportunity to practice, so practice, practice, practice. So you know just how much force you're gonna need. Also practice aiming the laser. That was one thing that I definitely had to get used to. So just practice aiming the laser, finding the laser so that, again, if you ever needed it, you're ready to go and it's almost second nature. That laser is really cool because once you switch it to fire, it automatically gives you that aiming laser. So you don't have to just guess that you're pointing it where it's supposed to be. It comes from the factory, sighted in, and we found that it really was. You can see on the water jug video that the laser is pretty much right where the ball hit. It does have the ability with these screws on the side here to adjust that laser, so if you find that it isn't sighted in correctly, you can always adjust it with those. And practicing is also important because until we kind of got a better handle on loading it and unloading it and that sort of thing, we actually had a couple misfires where the CO2 cartridge only worked once, and then another one where one of the projectiles fell out. But we've practiced enough now that I feel like we have a pretty good handle on how to load it, how to shoot it, and the last few times we shot it, we didn't have any issues at all. Loading and unloading are also not very difficult. To load the projectiles, you just turn that cap, pull it out, drop in three. This particular device holds 3 projectiles, and then you just real easy push that back in and turn it, put it in place. To load the CO2 cartridge, this one is pretty snug, so I use a screwdriver to help me loosen it, and then you can just take it out. You take that CO2 canister, push it in, just get it to the edge, stick that cover back in, screw it in, and it does everything it needs to do to get it ready. To unload it, make sure it's on safe, take out the projectiles, assuming you haven't shot them, and then open the canister cover. Then you put it on fire, point it away from anything, hit that trigger button, and the canister just falls right out. Overall, the PepperBall Mobile seems to be very sturdy, very well built. I've only had it for a few weeks, so I can't speak to how it's going to last for, you know, 6 months, a year. But so far, I've been very happy, very pleased. So because of that, I'm going to give construction and durability a 5 out of 5. Now onto testimonials and reviews. So we are able to purchase these on Amazon. You can also buy them direct from PepperBall. Looking at all of those reviews, the main things people complained about, a couple people said it would only shoot once and then wouldn't shoot again. I mentioned we did run into that, but when we changed that CO2 cartridge, it ended up being fine after that. So again, practice and make sure that you're getting it in there correctly and you're able to replicate that consistent shooting. Some people said it was difficult to load the CO2 cartridge, like they couldn't even get it to go in. I'm not sure what that was all about. The only difficulty I would say is like needing the assistance for me anyway of like a screwdriver to get that cap off and on. And then through Amazon, a few people complained that it came scratched. I'm not sure what that's all about. And then people complained that when it wasn't working well, they couldn't return it to Amazon. Maybe that means you buy it directly from PepperBall. So if there's an issue, you can contact them. Or I'm sure if you bought it through Amazon, you could probably contact PepperBall's customer service and they would help you out too. As always, we tell you the score we found. So for testimonials and reviews, the PepperBall Mobile gets a 4.3 out of 5. Now, for the whole reason you watch this video, should you buy this thing? The PepperBall Mobile retails for $149.99. I was able to do a Google search and found a 10% coupon. I have included in the description below a 10% off coupon as well. So right now, they're also offering free shipping. So right now you can actually get a PepperBall Mobile for $135 plus tax. And this device does come with some practice rounds as well as some of the active rounds. And it also comes with a few CO2 cartridges. So again, it gives you the ability to practice. You can also purchase additional kits with the CO2, with the inert projectiles, and with the live projectiles. So you can have as much opportunity to practice as you want. Overall, I think this is a fantastic alternative to a lethal self-defense solution. Just removing that hesitancy that may be there, you're able to protect yourself, deter someone from attacking, and also not be concerned about being lethal. And like I talked about, the flashlight function makes it easy for you to have it in your hand and ready at all times. So for the peace of mind that $135 could bring, I think it's totally worth it. And it was actually really fun to shoot and just watch those powder balls explode. So because of that, I'm gonna say, should you buy the PepperBall Mobile? I'm gonna say absolutely, get it, 5 out of 5. Hey, thanks so much for watching our video. While you're here, watch a ton of our other videos. If you have a PepperBall Mobile, comment below and let us know what you think. Or if we didn't answer all of your questions, ask those below. Most importantly though, subscribe while you're here. And take a second to follow us on Facebook and on Instagram.